Are you looking for the ultimate summer dessert that is easy to make and feels so very luxurious? Hi friends, this is Heather the Fed Up Foodie, and this strawberry crumble recipe has a perfectly buttery and crisp oat pecan topping. Within the recipe post, I share guidelines for using frozen strawberries. However, using fresh berries at the peak of their season really makes this dessert amazing. Either sliced or whole berries may be used for this crumble. Slicing them does release more of the berry juice, giving the crumble a more intense strawberry flavor. Just remember, if using whole berries, 5 to 10 additional minutes of baking time may be needed to create a tender strawberry filling. As you can see, it doesn't take long for the sugar to pull out the strawberry juice. The addition of cornstarch will help to thicken the filling, making for a juicy and yet jammy-like consistency. Baking the crumble in ramekins helps to create a beautiful presentation. Just make sure to place them on a sided cookie sheet for easy transition to and from the oven. Okay, to make a perfect crumble topping that isn't too dry or soggy requires a few key elements. The ideal ingredients, assembling in a specific order, and baking to golden brown. The flour will give structure to the topping, while the oats and pecans provide a delightful crumbly texture. Mixing the dry ingredients together and then adding in an egg will bind the ingredients together. Just make sure to thoroughly mix until the egg and vanilla are evenly integrated into the dry ingredients. Once mixed, sprinkle over the top of the berries. The final step of drizzling the melted butter evenly over the top will add in a richness and helps in achieving a golden brown and crispy texture. It is important to note that this recipe can also be made in a roasting pan if ramekins are not available. An additional 5 to 10 minutes of baking time is all that is needed. Once baked, let the strawberry crumble cool for about 10 to 15 minutes before serving. This dessert can be enjoyed warm or chilled and is wonderful with fresh whipped cream or vanilla ice cream. For more recipes like this and for weekly inspiration, make sure to head on over to thefedupfoodie.com and sign up for my newsletter where I share recipes and tips in helping to make cooking from scratch approachable.